He was a high-ranking thief. He was in charge of the north part of Israel.
Golan Heights, during the Yom Kippur War.
And they say that because of him,
Israel,
the Jews won the war at that time. Okay? I don't know why no one knows about that. But let me see. Okay. There was General Anders, who was in charge of the Polish army. And he took 70,000 soldiers, Polish soldiers, including within the 7,000, there were Jewish Polish soldiers. And they took him to Russia. Okay? Oh, thank you. Begin was, by the way, arrested there for being a Zionist. He got 8 years in Gulag. General Anders got him out, and he went with the rest of the army. Some Jews deserted there.
It's Tzva Andres, yeah, of course, the Polish army.
Yes.
From Asia.
Right.
Yeah, it's
Iran.
The whole thing is that there were a Polish general who took out those Jewish Polish soldiers, okay, including with them 1,000 Jewish children, okay? Bengal was one of these children.
Mm.
Oh yes, he came to Israel. He was 14 years old, okay, and then, and I think so later on when he was 18 something, he joined the army, and this is how we know about it. And there are a lot of Jews. They remain in Israel and that time Palestine because the people, the Jews there, they wanted to stay because they were military equipped, they know it, okay? And the rest of them, who didn't want to desert the army, they went with Anders to Italy, okay? And they were fighting over there with the rest of the Polish army. Okay, and then a lot of them got killed over there. And here you see it, there are the graves of the Jewish Polish soldiers in Monte Cassino. And here on top are the crosses from the Christians there were. You see, this is the whole problem we don't talk about. Okay, they only know one thing to say, that Poland is anti-Semitic. I was born here. I never had anything against Jews as a child, okay? I come here several times a year. I never heard any anti-Semitic remarks, okay? I don't know if you heard about, but first of all, Poland had three enemies. The Germans, the Russians, and the collaborators. Okay, they were Polish collaborators, and they were Jewish collaborators. Okay, and especially the Jewish police in Krakow. They were known as the worst one from all of them. Okay, I show you evidence. I was here. They used to come out in the night, and you didn't have the stamp. They took them out, and the next day they went to Belzec. And when I met with Polish president, and I said to him, the Poland should be ashamed of the Polish collaborator. And I, as a Jew, I am ashamed of the Jewish collaborators. I don't know if you heard ever about the people by the name Uls. No. Okay. They were Polish people. In 1943, they hit 8 Jews. Okay? Somebody denounced them. The Germans came in. Okay? They killed and they told the mayor of the town to bring all the people around there to see it. They killed the eight Jews. They killed that Mr. and Mrs. Ulms. She was pregnant. They had six small children and they shot them. Okay? And they said to gathering people around there and told them, listen, this is what happened when you trying to save the help the Jews. Okay? I want to ask you a question. Because I was asked that question many, many times. If I would have to save somebody, a friend, if I would do it, if I would have to sacrifice myself, I would do it. But I will never sacrifice my family. Is it a normal thing? If you have a friend, would you try to help him? Yes, okay. We have to know one thing, because in Israel, they're talking there were 100, 200,000 collaborators. They just took it from the air, because they never, never were able to count it how many. We know they were collaborators, okay? And they were, somebody right now said there were over 300,000 Polish people that would try to help, but they were afraid. It's possible, and I said not 300, there were probably 500,000. Forget there were over 20 some million, okay, of Polish people, okay? So this is my thing about
the... About the Polish new law and all the things, that's your opinion?
I tell you right away, when it came up, the new law, I was very upset. Then when I look into it, I said, no, tell you why. Because you know who is guilty for the whole Holocaust? Who is guilty, tell me. Who?
German.
Right, not Nazis. Forget the Nazis. You know why? Because the German people elect them to be Nazis. So I say that the German as a nation are responsible for the Holocaust because they helped Hitler, okay? Because I could see it, why it happened when I was in a concentration camp in the Germans. And just the German, the Wehrmacht, they were just plain soldiers. They were eating this soup, okay? And they just in front of the prisoners, I did not say Jews or not Jews, they were prisoners. They finished the soup, they spill on the ground, and those hungry people jumping with the spoon, picking it up and eating this from the garbage was on there. And those Germans, ha, ha, ha. You think so I ever forget this? Never. So this is what I say, the Germans are responsible. Israel Katz. You heard about him? Right? You see, if somebody is sick, have a cold, goes to the doctor, they give him a medication. This is about doctor keeping alive. There's no jokes. Believe me, I'm telling you the way it is. Because if I tell you what kind of a problem I have, you would not think. Just tell them. Yeah. Should I tell them?
You tell them.
I had yesterday cancers, 1, 2, 3. Then he was treating me, and I got better. And now they make a test, and the cancer spread different places. My bladder, what else? I forgot already. My lungs, whatever it is, and he keep me alive, because I tell you right now, I don't know if I will be here tomorrow, but this is my duty to be here and talk. This is it. So somebody sick, get a medication from the doctor. But for stupidity, there's no medication. Okay? Whatever he did is stupidity.
לא, 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 מה שישראל קאץ אמר זה שהפולנים, לא, לא, שהפולנים האנטישמים וזה בא מהם, מהחלב אימם. זה מה שישראל קאץ אמר, שהפולנים שותים את החלב אימם.
If we talk about this issue, but
in what?
The teachers, not the teachers. I'm working on my PhD in history. So, in Kielce, after the Holocaust, you know, it was a pogrom.
In Kielce,
and that's what we heard. You know, my family also from here. They, and then when they tried to come back home to Kielce. Yes. 42 or 45
key. I want to ask you, starting with the pogroms, I want to ask you a question. Want to finish this or continue with the pogroms?
What do you like?
Finish the thing. Okay, I come back to the pogroms.